Welcome or welcome back. My name is Nui. I go by they, them pronouns. I am currently studying graphic design at an art school. I will be a rising junior. I will not be sharing what university I go to due to privacy reasons. Today, I will be doing a what's inside my backpack. Just a disclaimer, this video is not sponsored at all. I've been receiving a lot of questions regarding to what I usually bring to school, what it's like to be a graphic design student, what are the materials I need, and I receive these questions from people that are both in design and that are interested in studying design at a university level, so I will be sharing what I bring. So I will be starting off with the backpack I use. I've been using this for 2 years. I have the Day Owl Slim Backpack. I received a lot of questions last semester about where I got this backpack, and I did not know that the brand Day Owl was having like a break or some sort. They weren't making backpacks then, but I think they have started producing them again. So yeah, this is the backpack I use. I've struggled to find backpacks that works for me in the past because I'm very picky with backpacks. I don't like backpacks that give that gap between you and the back. I'm the type of person that wears backpack straps pretty short instead of long because I don't want to, like, I feel like when the straps are long, that makes you have really poor posture, and I carry a MacBook Pro, so it's really heavy. This backpack, there's no gap between me, my back, and I prefer that, having like this awkward gap here. This is what the straps look like. It's pretty short. Another thing I really like about this backpack is that it has a luggage holder. This is really good for traveling too. I have this Kirby keychain I got in Japan. I don't put anything inside here, but it's just for decoration. And my partner and I have matching backpacks. We both have the same color and the same style, and when you put it next to each other, it's kind of hard to figure out whose is who, especially since neither of us decorate our backpacks. So mine's the one with the Kirby. There's 5 pockets in this backpack. There's the laptop pocket, there's this top part, there's the main compartment, and then there's the outside pocket right here. So I'm gonna start off with arguably one of the most important tools in graphic design, which is your laptop. So I have the 14-inch MacBook Pro. I used to have the rose gold MacBook Air. I forgot which model it was, but I had that for so many years, and when I decided to major in design, I realized that that laptop is not strong enough to support Adobe. Even though MacBook Pros are so expensive compared to MacBook Airs and the normal MacBook, I highly recommend if you can afford to buy the Pro over any other models, just because it's so much more powerful. It has the built-in fan. That's what makes the MacBook Pro so heavy, is that the fan inside helps keep the laptop cool and helps run the apps you want to use. And Adobe does use a lot of energy, and just having the Pro makes your life so much easier. And it is heavy, but it's worth it. All my professors have the MacBook Pro. A lot of professors I had the 16-inch, which is even bigger than this, but yeah. And this fits the 14-inch. I'm not the type to decorate my laptop because I'm boring, but right now only the bottom part has the clear case because I broke the top one and I've been too lazy to replace it, but I should do that soon. And then it goes inside this laptop pocket, and it fits really nicely in here. I wish I could use a tote bag or like something like a crossbody bag to put my laptop in, and I have used it a few times in the past, but it's the 14-inch is so heavy that it's I think it ruins the balance of my shoulders, and I don't know, I don't want to develop bad back or shoulder pain, so I recommend using a backpack even if it's not the most stylish. I think this backpack is very minimal and stylish. It goes well with anything. They have pretty nice muted colors. Yeah, I highly recommend this backpack. Next thing I put inside the laptop compartment is a simple folder. I usually just keep random papers inside here. I think when people think of artists, they think of a sketchbook often, and while I do believe that I should carry a sketchbook. Since in design we use paper a lot, I like to take whatever scrap piece of paper is in the recycling bin and just jot down notes when I feel like it. And I usually put them inside this folder. Right now I have this clear paper I used to experiment printing on last semester. I have some other paper mediums that my friend gave me. This is something I always carry, and I put it inside here. Next, I'm gonna talk about this pocket. This is for a water bottle. Oh. 미수가 하이트도. This is another thing I love about this backpack, is that it has a separate compartment to put water bottles, so you don't have to worry about spilling water inside the main compartment. The water bottle I've used last semester is this Hydro Flask. It's the 21 ounce in the shade Rain. This is the size that fits inside this slim backpack. The only reason why I got a Hydro Flask is because when I started going to university in person, I saw how so many people had a Hydro Flask. I don't know, I was just influenced by one too. But I think the only con for this is that it's heavy, so when you put water inside, it's heavier. So what I usually like to do is I like to bring this empty to school and then fill my water bottle at school. Obviously, I recommend everyone to carry a water bottle so that you can stay hydrated and stay healthy. Next, I'm going to discuss about this top pocket. It's one of my favorite pockets. But this, it's the smallest pocket out of the whole backpack, and I usually like to put things that I want to have easily access to here. Things I usually put in here are keys inside. I'm just going to show off my keychain. I put this My Melody umbrella holder. This is really useful for like when it's raining or snowing out and you need to use an umbrella and you don't have a place to put it. You don't need to have this, but it's fun to have. It's also very cute. Love My Melody. Next, I have hand cream, eye drops, and then lastly, whatever lip product I'm using at the time. Right now, I'm currently using the NARS lipstick. It's in the shade Thunderkiss. This has been my recent everyday lip product, so it's inside here nicely. I love this part of the backpack too. Being able to have the handles tied together like this, I feel like it just makes you look so much more put together like this than if it was just out like this flimsy. Next is the main compartment. This is what it looks like on the inside. There's two pockets here, and then there's my umbrella sleeve there, and then there's space right here. This is where I put craft related stuff here. So this is something I didn't know before I started graphic design, and obviously this depends on what university you go to and like what part of design your university focuses on. The university I go to involves a lot of printing and binding, and so I carry a pencil case with me. Chikin ramen. I use this because it's cute, but it's also very small and compact. Inside here, I have one ball pen, and then I have another pen that has a bunch of colors. I personally don't draw or write a lot in design, so I'm not super duper picky about the utensils I use. Next, I have a scissor. This is the one I got at Loft in Japan. You press here and it goes out like this. It's a lot more easier to use a normal scissor, but this is compact, so I like having this. And then next, I have two cutters. The school I go to, we do a lot of trimming. I made 4 books or 5 books last school year, and having a really good cutter is important, so that is why I have two, just in case if anything happens. Lastly, I have a bone folder. This is a tool you use when you fold pages. Oh, and I also have a fat Sharpie. I can't think of examples when I use this, but this has been really helpful to have, so I've been keeping it. This all fits in here. Next is this. This is my tech-related bag. Mifichan. Firstly, I have my MacBook charger, and I also have my phone charger just in case I run out of battery. Next, I have a hard drive to keep all my work in here just in case anything happens. I highly suggest you carry one even if it's heavy because it's a risk to save your work on a laptop. You don't know what's gonna happen. And next I have this, so I don't know what it's called, so I'll write it down here, but it's a connect to my laptop. You don't need to have like this huge cable management port, but I do recommend it just because it makes organization a lot easier, and it's also flat, see? And this helps minimize like making your backpack look so bulky. So here in front. And then lastly, this front pocket, it's very slim. I kind of put extra random stuff in there. Tissues. I always carry at least one bar, energy bar of some sort. I have a Clif Bar. Mints. I also like sharing mints with my classmates. I have a sun stick. It's the beauty of Joseon. Band-aids. Oil blotting paper because I have oily T-zone. Mints. In here. Ta-jang. Next, I'm gonna talk about like essentials. So first, my wallet, headphones. So if you've been around since my first art school vlog, I started off with the Bose QuietComfort 2, something like that. I've had those for I think around like 3 or 4 years, and it was starting to break down. So once that happened, I borrowed my father's headphone temporarily, the Beats by Dr. Dre one, and then I realized that I'm kind of tired of using noise-canceling headphones just because they're so heavy and they're very tight on my head. And I used the Costco Pros one for a while because I couldn't find a replacement, but I also realized how nice on-the-ear headphones were, and at some point I was like, I want to find a Bluetooth one that I like, and so I got this one when it was on sale. This is sold as a on-the-ear headphones, but I have really tiny ears that this honestly works as over-ear headphones for me. It like perfectly goes around my ears, and I can already tell that some noise is already blocking off, so this is the one been using lately. It's very simple. Yeah, if you just want everyday going out headphones, I highly recommend this one. So this, I've only charged this once since I bought it, and it's been lasting forever, but just in case I lose battery life in this headphones, I carry the just the normal earbuds. So like I mentioned before, I have a sun allergy, so I carry a sun umbrella with me, but I also use this in the rain and snow, so I have a habit of just carrying this. I'm also gonna just throw in double-sided tape because I used this a lot last semester. That's everything inside this backpack, and it's like still very slim. But yeah, this is what I'm gonna bring to my first day of school classes. There isn't so much I can prepare for classes. I think most art schools is that you usually just show up to your first class, and then they give you a syllabus, and then in that syllabus they would tell you what materials you need to buy. Most of my back to school shopping would be when school starts for me, so I will do a separate video on that. But yeah, that is everything I bring to school as a graphic design student. I hope that was helpful or interesting in any way. I know back to school means very different things for everyone, but I hope we can all slay. We will have a good time. Everything I introduced, I will try my best to link down below. This is my first time doing a real outro, but thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day.